Hey guys, I've got another knife review. Right now I'm going to be taking a look at the Spyderco Navaja. This is a another knife that I recently picked up on a trade, and I have to say I really like it. It's a awesome design. It's probably the most elegant knife I've ever owned. You know, even the more expensive knives I have, they're not as, I'm going to say, beautiful as this one is. I believe that this is just a really awesome, design. Overall, the aesthetics on this thing are just absolutely incredible in every way. It's just got a killer shape to it. And just everything about it, how it's designed, the fit and finish on it is just absolutely immaculate. So this is the Navaja. It's a blade design that goes back to 15th century Spain. So Ed Shemp, in designing this knife, he designed the blade after the traditional Spanish Navaja blades, which were kind of like an all-purpose utility, defense blade back in the day, and he just put kind of a modern twist on it, and it resulted in what you see here. And it's just an awesome knife. It's really nicely designed. It has some awesome materials to it. You have the S30V blade steel, very common blade steel used by Spyderco. Tried and true steel, very resilient. It's got some very nice carbon fiber. I have three carbon fiber knives now, or knives that use carbon fiber, and every single one of them is different. It's really odd how you can come up with so many different variations of how you finish your carbon fiber to differentiate it from other examples of carbon fiber handles. And even with the Spyderco military sprint run, you can see just how different the carbon fiber is in these two knives. This is kind of a dull carbon fiber that's kind of been finished with your standard G10 texture. You're really light dimpling, almost imperceptible, just how fine the texture is on this. Whereas this is very high polish, and it looks totally, smooth because of how high the polish is, but it's actually got some rather large dimples in the handle here. And I have to say, it's really, really nice. I think it's probably the nicest carbon fiber I've seen. And here's another example of carbon fiber variations. This is the Browse flipper. This is a very smooth, no texture to it, but it's got kind of a dull polish on it. Even though it's highly reflective, it's got kind of a dull polish. This one's high polish with some larger dimples, and this is a very matte finish with a very, very fine texture to it. So I just found it surprising how many different variations of carbon fiber there are, even within the same brand, being the two Spyderco knives there. So the carbon fiber on this is really, really nice. The fit and finish on this knife is just absolutely incredible. Probably one of the best examples of fit and finish I've ever seen on any knife, let alone $130-$140 knife such as this. The where the bolsters meet the carbon fiber, it is just so perfectly fit together. There's not the slightest gap anywhere between the carbon fiber and the stainless steel bolsters. Also back here on the spine, you have a stainless steel backspacer that's kind of been perfectly and imperceptibly sort of sanded alongside the stainless steel liners to look like they're actually one piece of solid steel. It's very hard to distinguish where the backspacer is and where the liners meet the backspacer. So it's just some awesome fit and finish there as well. The carbon fiber is absolutely perfect. There's no factory imperfections with it. The blade is just very awesome. You got a nice high polish on that cutting surface there. The shape of the blade is just really sweet. It's got a very distinctive shape, something that you wouldn't see anywhere else, and I haven't seen anywhere else. Also, you're not gonna be able to see, or you might be able to see here, but the Spyder logo is different from anything I've seen on a Spyderco knife. It's sort of like it's got sort of like a holographic feel to it. If you have the zero tolerance 560 knives, you can kind of compare this logo to the ZT logo on that knife. Whereas on the ZT, you have just a flat logo where there's no texture to it, but it looks sort of like it's got a texture. But here it does also have a texture, but it's also got sort of like a 3D look to it that's very similar to that zero tolerance logo. You can see the Spyderco and the CPM S30V, and this is a overseas produced blade, Taichung, Taiwan, and you can see the maker's mark up here. That's Mr. Ed Chimp or Shemp's logo. You have a four-way positionable pocket clip, and I like the pocket clip on here. It's sort of a, it's not, I wouldn't call it a black clip because it's not like the other black Spyderco painted clips I've seen. This has sort of got like a polish to it, sort of like a gunmetal. And I don't actually think it's even painted. It's got a very different texture to it. It feels like I'm almost touching the metal surface and not a paint coating, so this would probably be very resilient to wear, whereas, you know, those black painted clips tend to chip very easily. I think this would be a lot more resilient in that matter. You have your lanyard hole here on the bottom, kind of small. Don't know if you'd be able to fit 550 through there. You might be able to after some work. But the overall shape of the knife is really, really nice. You have a very nicely designed handle, which is actually pretty comfortable in this grip. There's a lot of, I saw some other people that were kind of in disagreement, saying the grip's not that great with this thing, but I think it's not bad holding it back here. And even if you choke up, kind of conforms relatively nicely. I mean, you're not gonna, you know, permanently attach your hand to this knife, so it's not gonna really matter how awesome the grip is. I don't know anybody who has to do hours and hours on end of cutting, and even doing that, you're not gonna be able to do that with one knife because you're gonna dull it down. So it's impractical to say that, oh, well, this handle style is not going to allow me to, hold it in my hand in a firm grip for days on end. Who really cares? Because you're never going to do that. But I find just, you know, gripping it like this is actually pretty comfortable. It's got some nice jimping up on the top of the blade here, and then also some jimping on the bottom. That's a very common for Spyderco. They do some really good jimping. just the lines on this knife are really sweet. Just an overall stats of this knife, I guess. You have a 8.5-inch length, a blade length of almost 4 inches, but a cutting surface of just over 3 inches. You have a lot of wasted space back here, where the bolster meets the blade. You've got almost 3/4 of an inch of wasted blade real estate there. So, I mean, that's just part of the design. So you just have to take it or leave it. Closed, it's almost 5 inches, 4 3/4. And there you can hear another big feature on this knife. That's the Spreadico Karaka mechanism, which I've heard some people have had problems with it failing. I saw one particular instance where there was a pass-around knife that had to get continual repair because the mechanism kept failing, but who knows, those pass-around knives, people really beat the snot out of them because they're not their knife, so they don't care. But I imagine just under light use, it's not going to do anything. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. This is the Spyderco Karaka. Spyderco Karaka, no. Spyderco Navaja, with the Karaka mechanism inside of it. Just one last thing. It's a pretty heavy knife because you have the full stainless steel liners and the stainless steel bolsters. So it's about 5 ounces. It's 4 3/4 of an ounce. One last thing I want to say about this particular iteration of this knife is this liner lock is the hardest and stiffest liner lock I have ever in my life encountered. It is nearly impossible to push it over to disengage the lock. It takes a lot of effort, and it really will hurt your thumb after a few tries, which is very strange, especially since it's got a really early lockup. You can see there, you know, there hasn't been any extra tension added to it. It's just from the factory got a very stiff tension to it. So I don't know about that. That's the only gripe I have with this knife. And it's not a fault of the design. It's just a fault of this particular iteration of the knife. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching. And please like the video and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And stay tuned for some more videos. Thanks.